Welcome to the 2016 Leeds Rhinos Annual Awards Dinner, sponsored by Grosvenor Casinos. Under-19s Academy Player of the Year, feel good?
Yeah, it feels immense. We've been on a bit of a roller coaster journey this year with 19s. Obviously, we lost our training base, same with first team. We moved about on that. We did go through a rough patch, same as first team. We've come good towards the back end, and I'm taking credit for a team that's done massive this year. So.
And because of the injuries to the first team squad as well, a lot of you 19s guys, when college work's permitted and time's allowed, you've been training with the first team guys. How much has that been a benefit?
It's being around first team boys is massive. You know, you get to see how they prepare for training, how they prepare for games, and what goes on in a full time environment with being a part time player. So you know, it's massive, beneficial for all academy players' games, really.
And you're in your second year with the 19s this year. How much have you enjoyed the season, especially with the guys who've come in and really added to the squad?
Seeing them first years come through and perform real well. It's massive because last year I was in the same position. I was coming through and I didn't know what to expect. It took me a couple of months to adapt, and Plume might a bit first to tell you that. And you know, it's tough coming through, playing against some fully grown men that are playing first team regularly. So it's massive seeing people like Cam making his debut, close mate as well. So it's massive.
Sie müssen mit Dessessen so weit alt bon zufrieden.
Ja.
For you uneducated, I didn't do German, I did woodwork, but broadly speaking, I asked him, you must be pleased with the season so far, Albin.
Yeah, obviously from a personal perspective, it's gone quite well. Obviously, my time here, I've probably struggled getting the consistency, you know, and keeping a first team spot, and you know, probably done that this year, just keeping injury free. You know, hanging around for these past few years, I've been able to learn off a lot of great players, which has helped me through. And yeah, I've enjoyed this season from a personal perspective. Obviously, it'd be a bit sweeter if you know we'd had a bit more success this season, but you know, take it for its merits and you know, move forward.
From quiet man to fans' favourite, Tony just whispered to him then, the fans now, mate.
Yeah, well, it's true, innit? They turn out every week and yeah, see a lot of what goes on. So, you know, I'm really grateful to receive this award and, you know, thankful for all the, you know, fans that have voted for it.
Not just the floods you've been looking after this year. That was just a bit of a side project.
The
pitch renovation work with Ryan, fastest time that's ever been done, yeah. And a small matter of trying to get a new stadium built.
That's right. I mean, on the 4th of January, I should have come back to work and start the new development work, which I've been trying to juggle with Kirkstall. Not only did we actually focus at Kirkstall on the ground floor, what Gary decided to throw into the mix that one afternoon, he just told me that it'd probably be a really good idea if we looked at the first floors while we were there and we allocated the space differently. And of course, Matt got involved and Davo got involved and everybody else from Carnegie got involved. And before you knew it, we had a first floor that was completely renovated as well. And then juggling the new development, which I can't wait to start.
We're a thousand miles from comfort. We have traveled land and sea.
So, after you score a try like that, do you go, "Oh, that were a good one," or when there's chance to reflect, you think, "Oh, I like that one. That were a good try. That might feature."
Yeah, I think you get a bit of a feel for it as you diving over the line. But yeah, I just think it's a team one there, isn't it? I just was lucky enough to get on the end of it. You know, those are tries you get excited about, and you know why you want to play for moments like that. So yeah, just lucky to be on the end of it, I guess.
So John, a good year for you. I know it's been tough for you at times, but you've played a lot of games.
Yeah, it's been a crazy year, really, you know. It started in Jacksonville, you know, going into the team and, you know, being first year at first team, really daunting, and, you know, the lads made me feel really welcome. Did a 10-minute talk in Jacksonville, and the lads found out rather a lot about me, but I won't repeat too much because my mum and dad didn't room. But overall it's been really successful, you know, playing in a World Cup challenge at 19 is something really special against Jonathan Firston, who's one of my idols, so, you know, I can't really grumble this year.
And going forward next year, cement that half-back spot?
You know, fingers crossed, I take every game as it comes, and, you know, I haven't been great all year, and I've had some down performances and had some good ones, you know, but for me it's just to, you know, continue to be a consistent performer and hopefully, you know, make it hard for Mac to not pick me.
And head and knee from yesterday, all right?
Yeah, I went into training this morning. I slept funny last night and my head started bleeding. So the doc put 4 staples in my head today, so that went right nice. But, you know, yeah, we're all right, so I'll be all right, I think.
Congratulations, mate.
Thank you very much. I think I played my 350th game this year for Leeds, and the novelty has never worn off, you know, whether I'm on sideline or on the bench or on the pitch. So I'll get the airs, standing up at back a minute, running out in that blue and amber jersey, running out in front of that south stand, where I started as a supporter, you know, as a young kid. And that's where I'll go back to when I finish playing. It's been a real good journey. And what a special year this year as well. I think a lot of people measure success in silverware, don't we? I think success is measured by the challenges that you've got to overcome sometimes, and where you start from, you know, the gap between what you expect and what turns out in reality is what causes you stress, and being able to bridge those gaps in challenges like we've had those years, I think, is how I measure success. And I can qualify that, I can prove that, because every time I've got up, spoke about Challenge Cup victories, Grand Final victories, I can get video evidence of it. I've always talked about that refiner's fire, I've talked about the legend of the Phoenix, you know, going through that that suffering, that perseverance, and you always get the fruits of your labour.
And as you said, awards are great. The press conference yesterday after the game, I don't know if a lot of people in the room will have heard it, but your head coach said this about you, that Jamie Jones Buchanan is just an immense human being.
Oh, it has got deep. That blue sofa that he talks about this year, it's got deep over the years. But he's been an immense coach as well. I think he's hit the nail on the head with speaking to Phil there. And something that's always stuck with me that Brian said since 2011 when he come is hold your nerve. He always says hold your nerve, you know, during those times when the wind's blowing hard and you're going through it and everybody's doubting you. And the If poems and Rudyard Kipling's. And as I said before, it's been immense. And you've just got to hold your nerve through that times. And other, he gets angry when I plagiarise some of his comments in that he uses against us. But he always says hold your nerve and obviously persevere, and when you're on that cliff face, you know, if you can stick it out, you're going to come off it a better person.
Rob, it has been a tough year, and you've been through some tough times. You know, we've had a glorious decade of success, but prior to that, you saw the building blocks that were put into that to get to that period of success. Have you seen that this year in this group of players?
Yeah, I mean, when I first started, and I know Danny's first year as well, we was thrown in pretty similar to this year, where we had a lot of injuries, a lot of senior players down, and obviously a lot of positions needed to be filled up by the younger boys. So this season reminds me of that, with people like John Lilly, Ashton Golden coming in, you know, we've got Cam Smith in the wings waiting. So the people who've got their chance this year, it's been a great year for them, but the experience and the stuff they can take from this adversity we've had is going to make them better players. And, you know, you'd like to think that could replicate what you know, that sort of generation when me and Danny came through can do. So although it's been a real down year, there's a lot of positives, and certainly the young lads are a real, real positive this year. You just gotta believe. Come on with me.
Just one day, watch this madness, colorful charade. No one can be just like me anyway, just like me.